Why would anyone consider switching from OBS to Meld Studio? That's a question I asked myself recently. OBS, after all, is free, powerful, backed by YouTube and Twitch, and a lot of people use it. The hype, though, surrounding Meld Studio is that it's super easy to use, and that intrigued me because easy goes hand in hand with quick. So to see if Meld Studio lives up to the hype, I've been building a brand new stream design for my stream. And you know what? Hours spent in OBS were reduced to minutes using Meld Studio. Let me show you how I did it. First things first, head to the Meld Studio homepage, link in the description, and hit that download button. It'll be ready before you can spell Mississippi. Now the fun begins. Let's add our streaming platform first. We're going to add Twitch. So we'll come up here to File, Preferences, and then we'll click on Add a Stream Output to be able to start streaming. Like I said, we'll add Twitch. I have to log in, so I'll go ahead and do that. And yep, that's the right one. Okay. Easy peasy, huh? And I have to enter my SMS code. Do that real fast. And click Submit. All right, we'll give it all the permissions it needs by clicking Authorize. The site is trying to open Meld Studio. Yeah. Wow, that was easy. Okay, we'll go back and we're going to keep the canvas at 1080p, 60 FPS for the frame rate. The video bit rate, I'm going to change mine to 7500 and the audio bit rate to 320. Because that's what I use on OBS. Keep the hardware encoder on. Enable clipping, which we'll get to in a future video. We'll clip it right here for Meld. And then I have my file destination for where my videos will go. The format, MKV. Looks good. All right. You guys ready? Let's build a scene. We'll start with a just chatting scene followed by a gameplay scene. So down here in the bottom left, we have our scenes. We're going to rename it chatting. Now up here in the top left, we have layers. Layers in Meld Studio are like sources in OBS, which makes sense because you are layering your sources together to create your scene. So we'll go ahead and we're going to add, I'm going to use the Face Cam Pro. So we're going to click on Video Device and it pops up right here in the left and then it'll say Select Device. In the drop-down menu, the only one we have available right now is the Elgato Basecam Pro. And boom shakalaka, there it is. That simple. And that for me is my just chatting scene. Now we will add a widget later, but for right now, we're just gonna keep it as it is. Now we're gonna add our gameplay scene. So down here in scenes, we're gonna click the plus button. It says scene again. We're just gonna rename it. I'm gonna call it game, just to keep it simple. Just like Meld Studio, simple. Okay, and then up here in the layers, we're going to add our video device again, and we'll add same camera, but we will, we're going to resize this to vertical, and we do that right here at the top. Watch this. Oh, so dope. Look at that. That was sweet. All right, I'm going to put it over here. All right, and I'm going to make it a little smaller, center it with the awesome snapping we got going here. And the corners are already rounded for me. I don't know why that is, but if you want to unround them, you just pull the circles. Pull it in to round and move them out to unround them. I don't know the proper terminology for that, but I want mine a little bit rounded. Oh yeah, beautiful. There we go. So now we're going to add our gameplay layer. We'll click the plus button again. We're going to click on display capture. There is no game capture option right now. Now it says in the drop-down menu, select a display or window. So we're going to click that. And I have the 4K 60 Pro, which is my capture card, which is really cool because that goes to my streaming PC. But here we are. Each new layer of Meld automatically goes to the top. So I'm going to click and hold on the Elgato face cam. I'm just going to drag it up over the capture card. And there we go. You can see me bright as day on the left there. So now what I'm going to do for a really cool effect is I'm going to add my capture card again. And click there. And I'm going to pull it down, resize it to where it's centered right here. Oh, I like that. Maybe get it off the edge a little bit. And that way I'll have my gameplay scene, the gameplay footage, and I'll have like a blurry version of it in the background. Well, the fun isn't over yet. If you guys watched Harris Heller's video on Meld Studio, he showed you how to do a drop shadow. But I'm gonna show you how to do a glow effect. So we'll just come over here to effects, we'll click the plus sign, and we will click on glow styles. And boom, right away, we have a white glow around our camera. But I'm gonna change that to a cyan, a blue. So we'll click the little icon over here to adjust the style. I like the outer glow, but the color, I want it, like I said, cyan. So we'll just double click on that and we'll move to about right here and make it a nice bright. There we go. Like trying to match my brand colors here. I think that's perfect. Okay. Click off of that. And well, there's some other effects here. We have like a center glow. You can put it in the inner frame, and then there is that's the inner frame glow, and then you have like the center glow, which is neat, but I like the outer glow, so we'll stick with that. And so that makes me want to adjust my camera a little bit. There we go, so we can see the left side of it, and then that makes me want to move this over to just a tad bit. Perfect. Anyways, and I'm gonna mess with that just a little bit more here. Click back on the camera, we'll hit that. The opacity, full opacity looks really good. And the size, maybe shrink it down just a little bit. The choke, I don't know what that is. Like, I know how to choke a lawnmower. Anyways. Okay, that looks pretty neat. And so we're just gonna leave that as it is. We will put a drop shadow on this smaller window of my game capture. So again, we'll just click the plus sign, and where's it at? Drop shadow, and we'll click the little button there on the left. The distance, now I can see that. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I'm gonna move it down just a tad bit, and I'm gonna soften it up, because I don't like a harsh line. We want a little bit of, oh yeah, it fades away real nice. So that'll give it some depth. We're pretty much done. Now, the other thing I want to show you guys are the widgets. So we're going to come up here. We're going to click the plus button again under layers, and we're going to go to widget. Now, we have the combo widget and the spotlight widget. We'll start with the spotlight widget. That is an activity feed widget. It'll show us who subscribed or giving us a cheer, a Twitch cheer, a Twitch follow, Twitch sub event. We also have a YouTube super chat, YouTube sub event, and a YouTube member event. So we'll line that up right under, I want it under my camera here. And again, with the snapping, it lines it up just perfect. I have it exactly lined up where I want it, easy peasy, a lemon squeezy. And we can make it bigger, of course, because, you know, for all you that are watching, it's going to be, it might be hard to see if it's as small as it was there a second ago. But heck yeah, that's perfect. I actually got to hide this dude's name because he's a friend of mine, and I don't want to be doxing myself, but that's where it goes, and that's how you do it. Very easy. Now, the other widget is the combo. Combo widget. Now, this is not going to work for me because I am not a Twitch affiliate, and with all that's happening over Twitch with them changing things up, we'll see. But basically, it's like a subtrain widget, and it's for Twitch cheers, Twitch subs, Twitch super chats, YouTube member. So I don't have any of that yet because I'm not a Twitch affiliate, and I don't have the amount of followers on YouTube to be able to do that, or subscribers, I should say. So go ahead and follow and subscribe, and we'll get there. I appreciate it. But anyways, we'll go ahead and delete that. But that's what it is. If you're eligible for that, you can put that there. I mean, we can demonstrate it, so I'm just going to put it next to my camera, and I'll make it bigger. Like right there is good. Get it lined up nice. And then I want to layer it behind my camera a little bit, so I'll put that behind. And we'll go ahead and preview the event so you can see what it looks like. I mean, boom, it pumped up the jam right there. So you saw that. Now, I will mention that the track down here, I already added my mic previously, which is through Wavelink. And it's the microphone effects channel so that I can have the effects that I put on my mic pumped right into here and sounded fantastic. So that was super easy too, because I've had a lot of audio problems. It's another reason I like Meld Studio, because they're making the audio for me very simple. I spent hundreds of dollars trying to get it right, and it's right instantly. So that's a huge selling point for me wanting to make the switch. Now everything's where I want it, so I'm just going to go ahead and lock it in place. In the next video or three, we're going to be talking about importing an OBS session using the Elgato Stream Deck with Meld Studio, so we can control Meld from our Stream Decks. And also we're going to be talking about the Streamer Bot integration. So if this video helped, give it a like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Peace.